Good morning. Happy New Year again. So 2012 is just about over. There's the last call for 2012. Say, I'm not gone yet. No, don't push me out. It was a much anticipated year. It was a year of breakthroughs and breakdowns. We saw lots of changes. I think lots of shifting is happening. I think something new is about to emerge. Everybody I've talked to feels really positive about 2013. Do you feel that? This is like, yeah, you know? So I spent yesterday pretty much reviewing 2012 in the news and YouTubes and just kind of seeing all the things that happened this last year. And probably the best witness of summarizing the year usually comes from jib-jab. You know jib-jab. So rather than showing you a video, I just have a small version of a part of what they wrote. And interestingly enough, it's to the song that we just sang. So it's the end of creation. The signs are every place. Ice melt at record pace. A dude who jumped from space. We had a Libyan crisis. The fiscal cliff was near. It's 2012. The end is here. We had a hot Zumba madam and 50 Shades of Grey. We all came out as gay. Stay out of Chick-fil-A. The world met Honey Boo Boo Child. We got funky Gangnam Style. It's 2012. The end is here. There you go. A little high. So when I look back at 2012, if you think about last year, remember how big the Occupy movement was, not only around the country, but around the world. It was like everywhere, and then it just sort of stopped. This year was the discovery of the God particle. There was a transit of Venus in front of the Earth. We landed a rover on Mars. We had Hurricane Sandy, which devastated parts of the East Coast, and we had Sandy Hook Elementary, which devastated our hearts. I did the top Google searches for 2012, and just a few are Whitney Houston, the iPad 3 and 4, the Hunger Games, Kate Middleton, Lance Armstrong, and Homeland TV show. So every single one of these words conjures up images. And of course, the 2012 Olympics, that was a wonderful thing. In 2012, Seattle Unity's focus has been on community, about learning each other's names and seeing each other's faces and being willing to be seen, being willing to step out and be seen a little more. We did a geographical study, and we did a lot of name tag Sundays, and Wayne helped us look at where are we from. Remember that one Sunday when we had people stand up and we were from, you know, Bothell and Kenmore and Des Moines and Bellevue and West Seattle and Issaquah. We were from all over, and so we're a mix of the Seattle area. We have been looking this year at community. Aaron began a project called So Many Faces of God, where we all came together at a recording studio and we sang So Many Faces of God, and then Rafe and other musicians and singers are going to do the lead on that. So that'll probably come out in 2013. Yes, we'll get to see that. We had a wedding in February. One of our chaplains got married and we did the wedding during the service. We had a home study group studying emergence. Linnea joined our ranks. And the community came together to begin serving snacks in the library, since Marge had been doing it for 10 years, 8 years, a very long time. So we stop and we look back. And I think that that's what's so great about New Year's and holidays and things. It's like we get to stop time for a moment. And we get to look back over 2012. We get to look back over our achievements. We get to look back over our failures. And we look back so that we can release and let go. And that's what we're doing here today in our burning bowl ceremony, in our burning bowl ritual. I think it's important that we do this once a year, at least, if not more often, where we stop, look back, and release. Because otherwise, we can get stuck in the past. We can get stuck in the past. It's like Lot's wife. When Lot and his family were fleeing Sodom and Gomorrah, they were instructed by God to not look back. And what did she do? She turned around, she looked back, and she turned into a pillar of salt. And metaphysically, that's what happens to us when we keep looking back, you know, when we're not moving forward and we're looking back. And we get stuck. And I think the way that translates is when I'm always looking back, then I'm not able to see not only what's in the future, but I'm not able to see what's in front of me. Because we can get this like tunnel vision of life is like this, when really it's like this. But when I get stuck in my perceptions and I get stuck in a certain way, it's difficult to see through it. And I think, too, the salt can represent limiting beliefs. Like, well, that's not going to work. I already tried that. And that's not, then, you know, that's when we know we've turned into a pillar of salt. So what we're doing here today is we're going to burn off that salt. We're going to release it. We're going to let it go so that we can create room in our lives. Releasing is a spiritual principle. We are breathing out today. We're breathing out. We are making room. Now, we know in our possessions that we have to clear stuff out in order to get more, right? I mean, when your closet gets too full, it means you got too many clothes, and you need to start releasing and letting things go so that you can make room for good. We recognize that with our stuff, but the truth is that same principle applies with our thoughts, with our emotions, and with places that we seem to get stuck in. So we're doing fire today. And what fire does is it is an ancient symbol, it's been around forever, and it's been used in rituals throughout the ages and throughout many different cultures, because when we burn something, we're taking the energy and we're transmuting it and changing it into another form. It's like the phoenix bird who, you know, rises out of the ashes. It's something new is born. And so that's what we're calling forth here today. It's very important that when we write things down, that we watch it burn and recognize that divine love is consuming the errors. Divine love is consuming the past so that the energy can be reused in a new and better form. So ritual and fire have great power, and I think when we come together in community, it's even stronger. And the thing that always amazes me about this service is when we do the burning, it's smoky in here, and it's a little bit, although that's why we have onion skin, and that's why you've got such a tiny piece of paper. You have to write really tiny, unless you brought your own. But what's interesting to me is even though we've sort of polluted the air, it always looks clearer in here, and it always feels lighter after we've done that, because we've laid down our burdens, we've released, and we've let go. So Aaron is going to lead us in a song to prepare us. And before we do that, I need to make sure that everybody has paper. If you do not have paper, please raise your hand and keep your hand up till the ushers find you and bring you some paper. And then after everybody has paper, I will ask if anybody needs a pencil. So right now, if you need paper, keep your hand up. And remember that we're writing very, very small. Okay, does anybody need a pencil or a pen? Okay, ushers, I hope we have pencils and pens, and look in the pews in front of you as well. Hold your hand up if you need a pencil or a pen. Patty needs one. Phyllis needs one. Second row. Has anybody got a pencil? They can borrow their neighbor. Pens or pencil? You don't need a pencil.
Thank you, Roger. This is an Om Shanti chant. And someone was telling me they're using the breathing during the chant by inhaling when we say Shanti. And so all you need to say is Om, and you inhale when we say Shanti. That's just an option. Goes like this. Om Shanti Om Shanti Om Shanti Om. Join us when you can. Shanti Om Shanti Om. Shanti Om. We'll keep going about 12 times. Shanti Om. Shanti Om. Shanti Om. Shanti Om. Shanti Om.
So I invite you to simply rest in this moment, and no writing just yet. And we are saying goodbye to 2012. So I invite you to just allow your mind to review this past year. What changes have you experienced in 2012? Positive and negative, what changes have you experienced? And right now, just sit and listen to your inner voice. Who have you said goodbye to this year? Through death, through ending of a relationship. And who have you said hello to? Who has come into your life that wasn't there last year? And how about traveling? Did you take any trips in 2012? What were the highlights? And how about your body? Just checking in with your physical self. and your work, your service. And as you look back over these different events and experiences of 2012, where did you get stuck? What has blocked your good? So I invite you over the top of the paper that you have to write these words. I now release these errors. I now release these errors. And I invite you to just start writing. What is it you want to let go of? What is it you need to release? What is your pillar of salt that needs to be dissolved? So if you need to keep writing, I invite you to do so, and just let whatever needs to come up, come up. We're going to do the burning in a moment. But first, what I'd like you to do, and this isn't the same paper you have, but to take the paper in your hands, and we're only going to tear it once. Otherwise, it won't burn if we make it all squishy and, you know. I now release these errors. Let's say that together. I now release these errors. I loose them and let them go. I loose them and let them go. And I let God have God's perfect way with them. And I let God have God's perfect way with them. And when you're ready, I invite you to come up. There's two bowls on the side and two at the front to burn.
Let go.
divine love consumes these errors. The energy is being reused in a new and better form. Divine love consumes these errors together. Divine love consumes these errors. The energy is reused in a new and better form. The energy is reused in a new and better form. So we have cleared out, we have burned, released, and let go of the past. Now we need to call in the good. Jesus tells a story about a house that was filled with demons. And so the owner came home and swept up the house and cleaned it, and the demons went running, and the house was really clean. And then the demons were like, hey, the house is really clean. Let's go back and bring our friends. And so they went back and they brought more with them. So we have just released our inner demons. We have released our limited beliefs, our negative thinkings, our blocks. We've released it and let it go. And so we need to call in the good. We need to call in what is next. So normally we have our white stone ceremony next Sunday, but we're having a TED Talk speaker next Sunday. She's going to be really good. And so on January 13th is our white stone ceremony, and it's also the kickoff for our 2013 program, which is called Who Are You Called to Be? To call in that good. So in closing, I'd like for us to do one thing. So if you would all please stand. And I'd like you to turn to the back of the sanctuary. Everyone to just turn to the back of the sanctuary. And imagine that you are saying goodbye to 2012, to all the blessings, to all the challenges. And I invite you to put your hands in the prayer position and bow to 2012 and say thank you. And so we turn, everyone turn now to the front of the sanctuary, and we say hello to the new year.
Hello.
Welcome. And we bow to the 2013, and we call in the good with this song.